A special KRFO interview with the voice of the Golden Gophers, Mike Grimm, who, along with members of the athletic department and coaching staff, are out and about here with the Gopher Chalk Talk Road Trip, which is coming to Owatonna on Wednesday, June 8th. Mike, thanks for the time. And what is the Chalk Talk Road Trip?
Yeah, thank you, Roy. We appreciate it. Always enjoy coming down to your neck of the woods. Owatonna is one of our favorite stops for sure. The road trip is basically a chance for the Golden Gopher athletic department, coaches and administrators, staff, and yes, you're right, even a radio broadcaster. We get to come out and thank all the Gopher fans in that area for coming out, driving to Minneapolis, St. Paul, watching the Gophers in whatever form of competition that fan chooses, whether it's football, basketball, hockey, and on down the line. And it's a small token, we know, but it's what they like to do. And we were this past week out on a four-city swing, and then this coming week we'll be on another four-city swing, which includes Owatonna. And it's always great to get down there. Of course, Federated is a strong Gopher backer, and I know a big time, advocate and impactful in the community down there and in the state. So we're thrilled to be coming down again to Owatonna.
Owatonna Country Club Wednesday morning on the 8th at 8 a.m. How does someone sign up? Can they still get involved and be out there to welcome you guys to town?
Yes, for sure. And the beauty is it's free. There's food involved as well. Again, it's the athletic department's kind of a thank you. The easiest way is to, and we do prefer to register, that if fans register, you'll need a ticket to get in. It's free, but you will need a ticket just so they can kind of help with catering and all that stuff to know how many people will be there. Have a decent idea based on past years. But the webpage is mygophersports.com. That's just a slight variation of the usual page, which is gophersports.com. The ticket buying page is mygophersports.com. There's all kinds of menu options there. Go to the road trip, click on the Owatonna trip. It'll look like you're purchasing, but the price is zero, and then you just print the tickets at home and bring them. It's pretty simple, and we sure hope to see a whole bunch of people.
The new director of athletics is already out and about and greeting the fans right away.
Yeah, Mark Coyle has been, he started, his first day on the job was the first day of this road trip. We went to Hutchinson and Perham on Wednesday. And then on this past Thursday, we went to Spicer, and we were at Grandview Lodge as well. So he intentionally moved up his start date. The initial thinking when he was first hired was that he would be a mid-June start time. And then he found out that this road trip was starting on June 1st, and he said, I got to be there for that. I want to get out and meet people and talk to people. And so he was able to work it out. And so his first day on the job was the first day of the road trip. I think what people will find when they hear him talk, I think he fits the mode of what Minnesotans generally want. I'm going to steal a line from a former coworker of his. This is not my line, but a person who worked with him when he was here the first time as an associate AD from 01 to 05. And they said basically Mark Coyle was a guy with high production and low ego. And I really think that's kind of the Minnesota way. They don't want braggarts or showboats. They want someone who's going to get it done with not a lot of fanfare. And at the end of the day, you look at the body of work and say, yeah, that's pretty darn good. So I think you'll find that when he addresses the audience next week. And I think he really does fit the mode of what Minnesotans, I think, look for in a leader.
What has the reception been like out and about so far? And it certainly sounds like, some tough questions are being asked of Mr. Coyle.
Yeah, of course. It hasn't certainly been the perfect year for Gopher Athletics. There's been a few self-inflicted wounds there for sure. And, they've been well documented. And I certainly wouldn't begrudge, newspapers for picking those stories up. And those things are being worked on. Mark Coyle knows that has to, get better in terms of off the field, off the court behavior. Certainly Richard Pitino knows he has to win more games. The Jay Robinson situation is kind of hanging out there. We'll probably find a resolution over the next, few months here this summer to see what happens there. And the sad fact of the matter is, I'm not trying to downplay any of that because they're all significant and all certainly are being addressed. But the sad fact of the matter is that they've overshadowed what has arguably been the greatest single athletic school year the school's ever had. The athletic Learfield Sports Directors Cup standings. It's a formula that kind of ranks all the Division I teams, and Minnesota strives to be a top 20 program every year, and usually they are. This year, coming out of the winter sports, they're ranked fourth in the country. Six Big Ten championships, a national title in women's hockey, but because of some of the other things going on, it's really gone unnoticed, and that's not to mention all the academic work that's going on. Has been unbelievable in terms of they have the most all academic, all district players and everything else. We could go on and on. I get it. But that's part of what the road trip's about, is to try to also rally the troops a little bit in this time of chaos.
There's some great local connections with Owatonna High School graduate Andrew Stelter playing for the football team, and Peter Jones went up to play golf out of OHS, and of course Carly Wagner on the basketball court just thrills every time she gets the ball in her hands. So there's some great local connections to our area that are playing for the Gophers.
Yeah, and, you know, that's been one of the common themes, and you know, I've really enjoyed calling football games, and Stelter, again, is kind of one of those Minnesota guys, you know, just a hard work. All of a sudden you look, it's like, yeah, boy, he's produced. You know, he's got a tackle for a loss, he's hurried the quarterback, he's got four tackles, and he just goes about his business, and I think, you know, he's going to get better and better each year. It's hard to believe because he played as a freshman. He got kind of thrown in there because of some injuries and really learned on the job, so to speak. But this coming fall, he's already a junior. It's hard to believe. Time flies. Now, part of that might be because as I get older, it seems time goes faster. But it's going to be fun to watch his final 2 years, because I think he's on the cusp of you know, potentially being an All-Big Ten caliber defensive lineman. And you're right, the others as well. And one of the common themes has been that, you know, each almost to a person when these coaches talk, you know, they want to recruit Minnesota kids. They understand that the whole roster, just by sheer numbers and those kind of things, math, it won't work, that they're all Minnesota kids. And in some cases, like tennis and swimming, they're Minnesota kids, but then they really recruit internationally. I mean, they have Canadians and, national champion diver 2 years ago for Minnesota was from China. So they will go worldwide, and I think that's good. It's a good cross-reference. It's a diverse athletic department, but the backbone really does have to be Minnesota kids like Stelter and Jones and Carly Wagner, who is just an unbelievable athlete and a great person. It's one of my favorite players to interview over the course of whatever the season is. But it's fun to watch her. She can run, jump, she can do it all, shoot the basketball. It's fun.
And Mike, who are people going to see on Wednesday, who's scheduled to be in Owatonna? And I assume Goldie will be along too?
Goldie will be there. He always is fun to get your picture taken with him. And he'll fire the crowd up early in the program and spin his head and do all of his traditional stuff and have some fun there. But it's a pretty star-studded group. Richard Pitino was not on this past week's trip. He'll be on this trip. Tracy Clays was on this past week. He'll be on this one as well. So he's taking in all four cities. Marlene Stallings, the women's coach, will be there. Don Lucia, the men's hockey coach, will be there. And Mark Coyle will be there. And then, you know, a bunch of what I guess we call the Olympic sports also. Mm-hmm. And I think it's always fun to hear from them. And they don't get quite the air time. And frankly, they don't get quite the stage time at these events that the top-end revenue sports get. But we still get to hear from them. And certainly fans get a chance to interact with them before and after the program. So I think this is one of the better lineups we've ever put together. It hasn't been often where both the football and men's basketball coach have been together in the same trip. Usually they try to, you know, lessen the load one goes on each trip. But in this case, Clays wanted to go on all of them. So Tracy Clays and Richard Pitino and Lucia will all be on this trip. So I think it'll be fun for sure.
All right, mygophersports.com. It doesn't cost anything, but you do need that ticket, mygophersports.com. Wednesday morning, June 8th, 8 a.m. at the Owatonna Country Club. Any other closing comment, Mike Grimm?
Well, we just look forward to it. And again, it's a way to get out, try to get some off-season excitement built up. You know, there'll be some other folks there, the Alumni Association. The Goal Line Club is trying to gain a few new members. That's the Football Booster Club. The ticket office will be involved. And, you know, if people want to do some, I think right now they have some, you know, two-game package deals that you can get a discount on some football tickets if you so choose this early in the spring or, I guess, the summer here. It'll be worthwhile. We have raffle prizes, autographs, and all kinds of stuff.
All right. Well, it's going to be awesome. Mike Grimm, voice of the Golden Gophers. See you at the Country Club Wednesday morning.
Look forward to it, Roy. Thanks so much.